coming through. Okay, just for the people on live stream.
1,400 people.
Mute the other. The people on live stream are just getting started here at the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. So, be another probably 2 or 3 minutes to get totally set up.
I'm glad you found the screen share, Mark. Can you speak at all there?
Thank you.
So I just promoted Joe and Michael. One of you want to describe what you have for your presentation or homework? That would be great. Michael, do you have anything to show?
People in live stream, we should be beginning shortly.
We're ready to go. Everything is ready. Yes.
Okay, thank you. Just give us one more moment here, and we'll. So we're on live stream. I'm on YouTube and
can you see if it's on HD?
Yeah, good. Okay. From my office.
Okay, I believe we're ready to go. Should we focus on Mr. Keshe now, Vince?
We are ready to go when you are. Everything is ready.
Mark, can you stop your screen share, please? At the top.
Marco, they want a screen share?
No, it was that person. Mark, yeah, thank you. I'm going to stop and restart the cloud recording, so just a moment, please.
Okay, just let me make an announcement that it is Wednesday, October 28th. It's the morning session for the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute Blueprint Teaching Week with Mr. Keshe. And people have been making coils and covering them with GANs and this sort of thing. If you don't know what those terms are, then you haven't paid attention in the last 2 days teaching. So, carry on. Mr. Keshe, I think he's ready there.
Are we ready to go?
Go ahead, Mr. Keshe.
Yes, sorry about that. I was too busy talking to another gentleman. The camera crew, there are about 3-4 of them here, recording everything for a final, release on Friday afternoon on satellite network. Good morning, good day to you. As usual, whenever you listen to this broadcast, as part of the Blueprint Week, we have opened a new channel, a new way in sharing of knowledge. We, as you were present on the 16th of October in Rome, we gave a number of units to World Ambassadors, and we gave a number of units to Keshe Foundation Ambassadors to be taken around the world. You heard from Armin yesterday that, as we spoke last night with the people in Armenia, the units are on the testing central laboratories of two nations by the instruction of the president. And hopefully, in the next couple of weeks, what they see, they proceed with. Last night, late afternoon, after we finished the session, I received a call from Her Excellency, the Nigerian ambassador, that they have tested the unit and the authorization has gone through, that the technology to be taught in Nigeria directly. And we are fortunate enough that Alex is in Nigeria, and national teaching through the government starts as of this week. They have proven the technology is what they need, and so the first test by the government has started in mass teaching in Nigeria. We finance most of the teachings from here, but the step in sharing knowledge through ambassadors, through the government, through the people, starts from Nigeria, which was one of the biggest wish for us. Now we start the process in Africa. So we've seen the dividend of the work. The scientists they tested their units, what they had here and in Nigeria. And so we start the proper teaching of full scale plasma teaching according to the way we teach in Nigeria, and then from there on, Ghana and Sierra Leone, Gambia and Cameroon come into operation. And with it, Namibia has already asked for feedback, and we'll see where we go from there on. In the coming days, we announce more developments off the back of the 16th meeting, and in the coming days, we release the second batch of the manufactured goods to be released worldwide. The first 1,000 yesterday, when I received a call from the Nigerian ambassador, was in response to what we planned to at least allocate equal amount to Africa from what is ordered worldwide. I have committed the Keshe Foundation to 1,000 units to be flown next week to Nigeria. So we keep to our ethos. The 1,000 units will be handed over to the Nigerian ambassador in Italy for them to ship into Nigeria in next week or two. And then Alex will teach people how to use it. So we see what we planned has come into operation, and the working units in the next few days, couple of weeks, will be actually used in homes in Africa. We keep full operational code, as I explained to Alex and Benjamin when they were here, as they are responsible for Africa division of the Keshe Foundation, that they supervise any units which goes to Africa, which means does not get done favoritism, or it cannot be resolved. It will be given freely to the people and they monitor it in there. Don't forget, Alex is already teaching heavily in Africa. He's been there now 3 weeks, more or less. And he has set up his own teaching structure, and we finance it from here. So, the good news, after more or less 2 weeks from the World Ambassadors meeting, is that we start the process. This week we fulfill all the orders, And next week, on the back of the orders we receive, 1,000 units goes to Palestine, and 1,000 units will go to Italy, and 1,000 units will end up in Nigeria. So, 1-4 is the ratio we set up, and we see we fulfill our commitment. So, by end of, let's say, mid-November, 4,000 units from the back of the first order will be distributed worldwide. We release all the data to be transparent, and at the same time, every time we release unit batches, we inform the Keshe Foundation with a confirmation from ambassadors. Now we come to the reality of what we spoke yesterday. We showed how simple it is, and in fact, what we're going to do is to go to the next step of assembling these units which you have made. The springs you made in a certain way, and if I can go to it, you made yourself, you tried to go three colors that it can be seen. You made the first coil. Ooh. I should not be touching this. No, it's just I touched the board. You're not supposed to hold the board. You confuse the electronics. It's very easy to confuse the system. You have the first coil. Then you superimposed a second coil on it. If I show you, you see something else, that the first coil, if you remember, had, maybe we do it this way. We call the green, it's important we get it. We call this green coil the small coil inside. That is, the green coil is the gravitational coil, the blue coil is a magnetical coil, and if you remember, we put the end of the gravitational coil back in itself, and it comes out. If you look, you have beginning of gravitational coil here too. So, your gravitational coil is inside, then it's gone through itself, and it comes out, and you have the magnetical coil, which is over the two. This is your, don't forget what you made. You made one turn of 70, and you made one turn of 140 or 150. This one is the 70. You have the same combination in 150. So, what you have is one coil, and then, if you remember that, we go back on the same thing, we put smaller version. This is the center coil, which came out. This is your inner core with its tail up, that's the beginning of it. Then we had the gravitational coil, which was over this, sorry, the magnetical coil. This is the first coin. This is a 70 turn. Then you had the bigger coin, which is the 150, the green one. That's the end of it. Then you had again with this the magnetical coil. Where these are the 2 points. Where on your gravitational point, if you remember, you went in and you came out. Where at the beginning of it, you are here. So if you look, you have two sets of coil literally inside each other. This is, for example, the bigger one. I'll bring it out that you can see it. This is the bigger one. Oh, yes. Oh, but I brought it up. I could feel it yesterday. You worry about him, he's happy, he's there. He's on camp. So what you have is the bigger coil and you have the smaller coil. Each one going through, coming out their own center. So what you have, in fact, is like two shells inside each other, like this. Totally cascading each other. This is very important. You will understand that center coil behaves as a gravitational. Excuse me, Fabio, can you focus on the camera, please, for next 10 minutes? So what you have is the gravitational inside the magnetical, and then itself the unit become gravitational inside another magnetical gravitational. This is important. So what you get is that, can we do it with this? Yeah, it still works. So now what is important is to get the result, how you connect. The connection is the secret to part of your success. What you have to do is, remember, you have gravitational and you have magnetical, two sets of. And then they themselves become gravitational magnetical field to each other. You create a cycle over a cycle to feeding the totality of the cycle. This is the reason for these units to be so powerful. So you have one set superimposed by another set, and then themselves superimposing each other's magnetic field. So what you do, you compress into the higher order plasma strength. Yes. So now, remember, gravitational goes clockwise, magnetical goes anti-clockwise. So what does this mean is, you have the orange bits, the orange end is the end of your gravitationals. You started, the gravitational goes clockwise, it comes out, and then the same in here. You add your gravitational from the inner circle to the beginning of the bigger gravitational. So you add gravitational power into gravitational power. So it means you absorb more from your environment. Whatever you can, you take it. Then, you see, it goes out and it comes back as end of the orange again. So, now you connect your gravitational from here to the magnetical on the clockwise. Now what you collected from your gravitationals, you feed to the inner core magnetical that you can boost and compress. Then, as it goes through, magnetic goes clockwise, you connect your other end of magnetical back to, if I go that way, to magnetical of the big one clockwise again. You collect and then you connect to the clockwise. So, now what you are left with, if I can show it, is, let's see if you can get a collection of colors here. Tell me if you see the yellow. You have here, and you have here, 2 points. You have beginning of the gravitational of the smaller, 3, and you have the end of the magnetical of the bigger 3. These are your 2 points of reference. We consider the gravitational as negative or as input, because it absorbs in, and we consider the magnetical as the positive or what goes out. The whole starter process, this gives you the first set. Remember, you had one double set. Excuse me, Fabio, stay there, I got to do. You remember, you take from gravitational, which you've gone through, into the gravitational of the bigger, and then you go through magnetical on the clockwise to go. If you look at it in a very complicated way, I have to find a color that we don't have. The circle starts from here, it goes through itself, goes winding up, goes to the gravitation of the bigger one, increasing the gravitational field forces. Then it feeds to the magnetical clockwise, to the bigger clockwise, and you have a total field forces. So what you got left to connect with is this point and this point. If you look at the increase of the plasma, you're looking at very minute amount of matter state of plasma, which are releasing the energy continuously. And if you look, something which is important, and I said to you to do when you started it, any wires which connects to any of these, to anything else, has to be nano-coated wires. You cannot use ordinary wires. That's why we ask you to nano-coat some wires, that you need these wires to be able to connect from, you do again not only nano-coat, you put the same process, you put this through the plasma, because then they still carry the forces. So what do you use these for connection to whatever you needed. This is known as one plate. This is the basic foundation of the power supply, how you add, how you increase power, and how you go to different size. So this, you can put this, we asked you to get yourself three plastic trays or plates. This sits on one plate. This is the basic for your first plate. But for you, when you are doing this, there is one thing important. When you put this together in this shape, you see you have a circle free in the middle. Remember, you are working on a universal condition. What does a universal condition mean? If this is the size of the plasma of the sun, you need a sun in the middle. This has become the sun for the bigger one. But to guarantee an indefinite supply, you need to put what I told you, to put some of that GANS in your paste shape. You place, you take a ball, any size ball, which can have fine, that fits into this, and it can be nano-coated, and you place it inside. So you create a sun, you create a source of energy continuously. That even when the layers are not releasing continuously, the center sun gives you continuous supply for decades. So what you do? You place a sun in the middle. Just fill up, depending on the size of your ball, not the liquid condition, the paste condition. When I speak about the paste, this is the paste I use. I can show it to you. It is fairly robust. You can see it. This is a GANS, a specific type of GANS. And you can see it. It is like a paste. It's like a glue. You want to see it?
Yes, please.
This paste is source of the energy for your systems for a time to come. So what do you do? Okay. So you put this paste into a balloon. The first ones we tried a balloon. We put it in the balloon. And you place the balloon, you know these water balloons children play with, fill it up with water. This is what we did for testing. But you can get a small plastic ball and fill it up with a paste and place it in the center. This gives you the guarantee of what you call the guarantee of the energy supply, plasma fields, as long as you like. Where did I put the cap? There it is. So you need this source. You need this because this way you create continuous field in your system. I forgot something, Marco. Could you? Oh, Fabio. It's okay. Fabio, can you go to downstairs and ask Caroline for the stacker unit, the white stacker unit in the cupboard, please? But the original, the prototype of these, they're in the cupboard. Two of them, can bring it up. I forgot about it. So what happened? Now you have a plate.
Mr. Keshe?
Yes.
Okay, there's just some questions of anything specific in that paste for GANs.
I have used this GANs is what I made. It has a lot of other different type of GANs. What the beauty with it is, if you looked at the pictures when I was showing it, it has a bluish. It has a SP3 diamond structure GANs in it. I've shown this before years ago. I built this. It's worth current Chinese what do you call it? Valuation, about $4 million a kilo. But you can make it yourself. It's a very rare superconductor. When you add it, what it does, the reason I show it to you, you can see it. This allows a different dimension release of energy from the plasma, because then the plasma works as a transparent plasma. Ah, thank you very much. Just leave them there, please. If you look, it's a bluish green. It's originally very, very blue. It's a SP3. I've seen some of you have managed to produce it, but you don't know what it is. It's it needs time. It took me a long time, but now it doesn't take that long because the process is much easier to do it. So what it does, you need the SP transparency because radiation fields through is totally different. Radiation of the fields through SP3 are very different when you use SP3 instead of what you call in a gas state, in a diamond structure state of SP3. One day when we have time, I'll teach you. I'm going to close this one because it dries very fast. This paste in a liquid form is what I have used for this material to do the GANs coating. So now you have your plates. Let me see what I can get here out that I can show you. These are the original prototypes when we started it. If it doesn't matter, I'll show you another one. This is one of the plates. If you look in the system, we have three of them. So what you do, this is one tray. When you open it, you see the setting. One sits in the center core. If we can get it in, because this is built for another size, the other one. And the other one sits in the outer core. This is the way they sit. This is the way you set them. And in the hole in the middle, when you see, is where you place the paste, the mold. So this is the formation. And what you will see, the end product, you see that? Somehow my cameraman gets the last shot. So what you see is the gravitational set, magnetical set, and the hole in the middle where we put the paste ball, where the sun is, it radiates. You understand now, you have three sets, three stacker of these, and you lock them. So they're out, you already made the connections. So you have two wires sticking out. One is the magnetical of the bigger ring at the end, and one the gravitational of the smaller ring inside. So when you're done, don't forget three golden rules. End of each wire. End of each wire, when you've done your connection, yours are not as long as these, you have to burn, to turn the field back on itself. If you don't do this, you'll find out, big problem. Energy loss, field loss into the atmosphere. Every single time you work with a plasmatic nano-coated system, you close your loop. It's like your fingers. If man's fingers were twisted backwards, our intelligence would have been totally different. Because you would have absorbed most of our energy fields back. Now we are in open. As much as we receive, we give, but there is not that much conservation. So, golden rule. You twist the wire all the way, every single one. If you see a single wire which is not twisted, you have a loss. The second golden rule is, you notice I wore a specific tie. You always say, I wear a tie for a specific reason. What does the tie have? The screws, nuts and bolts. In the world of plasma and nanotechnology, they don't exist. You cannot screw two nanomaterials cans together. So this is what they call is sentimental ties. One day they say, ooh, man used to use the screws and nuts and bolts. Yes. We have one. He's asking, why don't we have a tie for a plasma? We already have one. So now, when you connect your systems together, I'm going to take one for example, because then it's good enough for the rest. When you connect one end to another, when you set up your system, you're connecting, for example, your gravitational to magnetical, and you got to the point you want to do, the only way you can connect nano-coated material is by twisting. Do not twist tight in, because it creates a different problem. Two twists or so, with a turn at the end, you can cut your wire, and then when you cut your wire, just tip it with what I asked you to keep, some of the caustic water. Just tip it on the top. By the time you do the rest of the work, a nano layer we coat at the cutting point, there is no matter state, you still sealed everything into a nano coat. So now, you have three stackers. As you see, we have three sets here, because of the pre-production test. If you can focus on it, we have three sets of the big one here, and three sets of the small one. Yeah, Marco wants me to hold it up. So, you see the whole set is in that form, that you can see it, and we have full three sets. Now, you made the first plate. You put the sun in. You'll find out, if you've forgotten, your centerpiece in the middle, your energy performance will be different. You will understand why. I'm going to put these away and explain to you something very easily. You understood something very simple, that every point on this was calculated the way even the material was put in position. What you have now is you have three trays. One, two, this is strange, my ring turns it up. You have the three trays. Look how it's been set. In the center of each, you have a star. Yeah, my tie was doing it. So you have your star. Now you understand. You have created three stack radiating, and you had your three stack, if you look at these, like the smaller ring inside, and these as the bigger ring outside. Now you see the symmetry in control of the plasma in totality. This system is indestructible. This system will run for centuries, because leakage from this system is very minimal, but the concentration of the field sits here. Here you absorb and feed in, here you absorb and you feed in, your center plate condenses. It's a huge powerhouse. In fact, if you look at it, if you can go on a yellow, the powerhouse expands, and as the more you use the system, it expands, and it expands, and it expands. Because it feeds, it absorbs from the environment to the same line as you thought energy is going out, is absorbing from outside in. So, if you put it in a high intensity magnetic gravitational field, they become more powerful. It's not only feeding itself, don't forget, you created the gravitational line inside this. Inside this, there is another gravitational. So, the system is a highly vibrant, dynamic, energy absorbing, and it's all in nano state, all in the GANS state. There is no matter state. If you scratch your wires, make sure you nano coat it. If you get a spark on your system, it means somewhere you have created a cut. Make sure when you finish with your system, even just before you put these into the set, just tipped all, just the ends, all the connections into caustic. That in time will cover itself, a soft caustic. So now you have the operation of the system. But now, how do you connect the three trays to each other? Don't forget, if you made your connections long enough here, you have at the end, let's go up, maybe it's here better. Here, you have an entry. Here, you have an exit. Each plate has an entry and an exit. entry is to the central gravitational of the smaller. What do? You connect the bottom tray, if we call it number one, no, it's already there, understand. There's no use. So here you have a magnetical exit, and here you have a gravitational exit. The same is with here. The same is with here. And the same is with here. The same is with this one. And you have the same with this one. The way you got to connect it is, this is the line to out, to your power supply, to your grid, where your energy comes in. This is beginning of the circle. You connect the entry of this to this. You connect the entry of this to this. So you put them in series to each other. Exit of one to the entry of the other, entry of the one to the exit of the other. At the end, you have one entry and one exit. Entry goes to your socket, to the power supply. And you connect the other end to your load. If I can write it. Here, we're on the edge, we always have a problem. So, now you see the system. You have a full connection. And you can see the structure. Winds. We have a very schematic drawing of this, you downloaded yesterday, I sent to you. Can you put that up, please?
Okay, I wasn't expecting that. Let me find it.
Then you see it, how it's done. When we release the final blueprint, you will see it. So, your homework today is connecting all your wires together, all the plates together. Then, now, you have, what you have is a total, absolute plasmatic environment. This is what you have never been used to working. In 2 years, making other materials, making the GANs, now you are in charge of the system. There is a path of work where you can increase the number of the stackers to increase power, but there is much easier way to do it, totally different way. You can, on one plate, or what I call one set, produce to carry resistive power of 2 kW. But if you set it in a special way, you can increase it to 10, 20, 30 kW resistive. But these units which you receive is certified for 2 kW resistive.
Should be there now for you.
Now you can see it schematically with the way it's done. Yeah. Okay. Now you see this is of the total blueprint which is in the hand of the government. You see the magnetical coil, you see the gravitational coil. Can you go to the next page up, please? It says Keshe Foundation Research and Development Group. Keshe Foundation has ARMS Technical Power Cell, which is commercial, and the research and development. It's our registered companies, which we work on there. You see it, how the coils are connected. This is just done yesterday by, completed by this week by Brennan. We do blueprint exactly across all the manufacturing the same, that we understand if anything goes wrong, where it is and how, if there is improvement, we can all improve. Can you go to the next page, please? These are off the blueprint. These are exactly the circuitry you need to connect into your banner. Okay, thanks very much. You can take it off. Yeah, just take it off the screen, please. Okay, so now you see it is the structure how you put together in a three stacker. You can increase the stacker position to 4 or 5, but will not be as good. Perfect. What is it? Ah, okay. Now you've seen the structure. You have a wire out from the power to go out to the power supply, where you're going to put, not for the power, but for frequency, which you get from the 50 Hertz, and the other end, the load end, comes here. You see, there is no matter-state interaction, and what you get here is total plasma. This is what I explained to you. In the coming days, in the coming weeks, when we take these wires out and put totally nano-coated wires, you decide what you want to take from plasma. So, now you see how electron vibration is frequency, the way it's set for the power supply, allows the release of a plasma power. It's the conversion of release that whatever you want to do at the end of it. That's why when we showed the drill, the two different drills, one American and one European, one 110, 120, it could be done. Because now the system decides on what it wants to give out according to the reference point of the frequency. If you manage to put a battery DC on one end, you will get plasma DC on the other end too. This gives you a different proposition, and that's what you use for the car unit. With a car unit, the battery of the car itself becomes a DC supplier, AC supplier, and you utilize it for itself. So, Monday you nano-coated, yesterday you sprang, no, nano-coated and made the springs, yesterday you did the nano-coating and putting it through the GANS state, today you make the connection, and now you'll find out all these have to be absolutely bone dry. Because if you have moisture anywhere in your system, you plug it in and it blows and it says, my God, I've done something wrong. Or it doesn't work. It means you have not dried the system. It means that you just got to wait a little bit longer till it dries. If you put your system back by accident in the moisture, you might get the sparks, but you might not get, because the pattern is set by itself. The other point which you have to remember is, once you connect the units to the power supply and to the load, the fundamental work of the plasma starts. This is the beginning. What does this mean? Plasma never stops releasing its energy. It's not a switch you can switch off. It's not something you can say, I don't want it to work because I'm not using, nothing happens. While you put your system, you plugged it in, and you put it on the circuit in the house, and there is no load, but it's connected to the wires across the house, the plasma field force continuously nanocodes the whole life. So, you think you unplugged it, but the process carries on. And strange enough, on both ends. You will be nanocoating all the wires in the house, and you'll be nanocoating the grid for the government. So, you can go to the government and say, we are selling you, we are making you superconductors, can we get paid? This was your dream. But in the house, you find out that you have a superconductivity, and you can see this. In a few weeks time, if you go around the house, and you take the wire out of the plug, somewhere in the house, and just take the plastic away, you see your wires are black. They themselves been nano-coated by plasma, which is the most beautiful way to do it. With acoustic, you force it. With the electric current, you force it. But when it's nano-coated by plasma, the superconductivity is so efficient, is so perfect, that you can literally after a few weeks, or a few months, 2 months, take the unit out and see the same thing has happened to the wires of your house as it's happened to here. Nano-coated material, perfect nano-coating plasma. The wires in the house start doing what you never thought will happen. They become your power supply. So, all the wiring you put in the house now becomes energy source. And the more power you put at the end, the more power you put in the consumption end, the more nano-coating you will do. And if you can take your unit out in 12 months time and do a test and see that the house is running without any power supply, means now you've become self-sufficient. The nano-coating will take the place, and funny enough, in the present structure of the buildings, we have chalk, we have different kind of salt in the air, and your nano-coating inside the house does something very strange. It creates its own GANS coating. I brought this box yesterday, and it was clean. And I washed it this morning. And if I leave it here tomorrow, in a couple of days you see it start creating salt. And that's how you created the GANS, by introducing moisture and salt. So, now, in the long run, all your houses, all the nano-coating which you've done, all the wires, they become power supply. This is what is in the pattern. This is what, if you go to the original web pages of the Keshe Foundation, has been there. That for the houses, you don't need any coating. So, now you have created a system which kicks in a universal energy system. There is no 100+1 that you become creating free energy. You create a new fuel supply, a new energy supply. And this is why you will come to understand in the next couple of days, when you start making your units, The first day, first 2 days, first week, you don't see such a big improvement because the system energy is nano-coating. Till it doesn't nano-coat, it does not go anywhere. It has to nano-coat online till it does not nano-coat this one, it will not come to this one. So you don't get a jump, it goes there. If you put a voltmeter, if you put a measure meter before or after your supply, the power unit, you will see it goes, for example, at 2 kilowatt, it goes 2.1, it goes to 197, it goes to 195, it goes back to 210, it goes back again to 195. After 2 or 3 days, you see it drops down. Because that going up and down is the energy is using to... It fills every single atomic structure, yes. Yes, because somewhere down the line, there is a drop in resistance. So somewhere in the line, the favorite word of Marco exists, gradients. And that gradients, I'm going to wash my hand, that gradients creates the condition for the change or transmission of energy. Now, you have to decide how much energy you want to take from the system. How much you want to push it? Do you want 1.2 kilowatt? Do you want 1.2 kilowatt? Or do you want 2.2 kilowatt? Or do you want to increase it to 6, 7 kilowatts? You can't do more than 2 kilowatts on these systems, you melt your plates. The copper wires won't melt, or if they melt, they reconstitute themselves because they are nano-coated. But you will melt your system because, especially at the beginning. I explain these systems like babies. You can't play football with a child which is just born this morning. You gotta let it grow. Then you can play rugby and football when it's ready. To play rugby and football at high power with these systems, you need 2, 3, 4 weeks. And secondly, the pressure of the plasma demand has to be built up in a very slow way. Those of you who get the system and get excited, and then plug it in, then you find out you're in a big surprise. And it says, it broke. Look on the insert when you receive the box, says maximum 2 kilowatt. We have certified that 2 kilowatt. The other point you have to remember, plasma is DC. Plasma is not AC. Polarity is absolutely important. You got to know which end of the animal you're holding. Is it his tail or is it his head with his teeth on it? That's why every single unit has one of these on it. Or if you don't receive it, you have to dictate the phase. If it is on phase, off phase, live or neutral. And you connect your negative part or the beginning of the gravitational point to the power end, to the phase end. This is important. But don't connect yet because there is a piece missing. That comes tomorrow. This system is not complete yet. You will understand when we explain tomorrow. The whole purpose of this week is to teach you step by step. Those of you who are behind, hopefully by tomorrow we catch up. And tomorrow you can assemble your system. We'll show you how to do it. You made your trays. Do not connect it because you'll be in for a big surprise. System still needs a piece to be added to it, actually two pieces to be added to it, to work perfectly. understand something. When you know you're correct, you don't need to be afraid of anyone doing anything. You can put things right. We know we are correct, we know we changed the course of humanity, and now you see it how. Because I show you very simple. In the coming days, I can show you even today, you don't even need a power supply. But then the mayhem breaks rules in the oil industry, and you don't want to be there. We give them 3 to 6 months to adjust, and then if somebody breaks through, we release it. If they don't break through, we're still playing, we're still alive, we're still in Keshe Foundation, we're still teaching. But we have the knowledge even today to replace this. You got to understand, this technology is to be correct in every aspect. And in time, the enemies of the Foundation, we regret, but they brought us a lot of attention from their work. They served us very well, and they're still serving us. But you got to realize, everything has to be in balance. What you put in, what you take out. How much you put in, how much you take out. You push too much, it will not go. Go back to the teaching, if you haven't been with us. Let me explain to you what happens. Why you cannot go over more than 2 kW till you set your system. This has been explained well in the teachings of the Keshe Foundation. In plasma, if you look at the field strength, is a continuous. This is the magnitude of the power. It's one continuous level of field, which is released by the system. These systems work as plasma does, a continuous, what is DC. If you put a resistive AC on, don't forget it's the full spectrum of the plasma strength. Alternative current works on this level. When I touch it, it goes wrong. So, if it's the strength, it's somewhere around here. What happens, what you get as heating that gives you a barrier of 2 kW, is that this plasma has to reduce in the strength to come to this level. That's where the heating comes from. That's where the resistance comes in. When you put your resistive systems for a long time on work, then the plasma will teach it, will nano-coat it, will understand to use the plasma strength, and then, if you look at it the other way, gradually comes up to be somewhere here. So, you change the behavior of your material to work as a nanomaterial than in a matter state. And that's where you save yourself. You pay for that much, and this much will come from your plasma. This is the 40% or so, which you pay, because gradually the plasma learns, teaches your system, and then it builds up. You nano-coat your system. Do not use transformers to, to charge up. We know what happens. Do not go to the limitation of 2 kW in the first 2-3 weeks. I teach you on Friday. We told you, if you want to go to 7, 8, 9 kW, by the end of the week, we put an auxiliary unit for sale on the website. Which means you add auxiliary unit to the system in your house, and you can push your demand to 10 kilowatt. Cannot be done with this system, it's impossibilities. But you can change the structure to increase the demand into higher level. You know what, you all know it, but you missed it. You've been looking at it for all this time, for months, but you missed it, you don't understand why. The auxiliary unit you need, and on Friday I explain to you why and how it happens. These units cannot deliver more than 2, 2.5 kilowatts. If you come back and tell us it's burned, we tell you very easy. It's been told 2 kilowatts, we can put it on any tester anywhere in the world. We run it for months, at 2 kilowatts nothing happens. When you overload it, you damage it, it's your problem. The system inside has a thermometer. 55, 60 degree, it blocks. The system doesn't work, you say it stop working, it means you are overloading it. You have to change the last load which you put in, give it time for the heating to reset, and then you can use the system. If you come back with a burned unit or a buckled unit, it means you overloaded it, it's your problem. 2 kilowatt is the guarantee on the system, it's been tested. It's a certification, CE certification which has gone in, and the American standard confirms 2 kilowatt maximum. Total resistive on the circuit. In a different section, you can increase it and change it. So, now you understand where it comes from. You're trying to put a cat through a needle hole, it doesn't work. Cat is a plasma, a needle hole is a vibration of the electron. So, you have to start educating yourself to use it. Then, you'll find out if you don't have any resistive, interesting point, from here, all the way to here. Energy of the soul, emotion, matter state, and if you take this matter state and expand it, you can have hydrogen, nitrogen, gold, plutonium, and everything else you need. So, now, you can decide if it's going to be vitamin C or vitamin D. You like to have meat or fish? Would you like to have bread today? You absorb the energy from the spectrum of the plasma you have. This is what I explained to you yesterday. In the coming time, you decide. You'll get coming out, you won't see any water, but the energy of water is there. But if you need the physical water to wash your hand, you press conversion from a plasma to a matter, you get water gushing out. A lot of you have been trying to do this for weeks. Understand how the system has changed. Now, you have the river of energy of the universe in your hand. It's you who decides, you want a little bucket, a spoonful, a bucket full, or you want to fill up a swimming pool. All of it can be done instantly. And then, if you understand this process, and you understand the limitation of kilowatt hours is in your head, not in the system, would you like 1 gigawatt. Because the system gives you totality. It's you who chooses what you want from it. If you understand the operation of the plasma, the release of the energy of the plasma, you will can convert the plasma energy into motion. You can use the plasma energy into positioning of the strength of the plasma from one point to another. You want to be here, you're here. 5 seconds later, you want to be in New York. You create gravitational magnetic field of the strength of the New York at the position, you're there. This is the biggest fear of national governments, and we've seen it in the background. The discussion has started. The biggest fear of us was him releasing this, what we're going to do. He's done it. At the moment, discussions in government is, we have no control. How are we going to handle this? They thought it would never be done. They blocked enough. But now, in past 24 hours, through our sources, there is a discussion starting in the government. What we thought he'll never do, he's done. He's released the whole caboodle. He's caused enough problem now. We have to see how we can handle it. They know the problem starts in a few months' time, in a few weeks' time, when number of units, thousands and thousands goes, and people start using it, and hospitals will be empty from patients, because when you don't have a pain, you can do it yourself. There is no need for doctors. Petrol stations will be free, and all the other hassles which has started. You do not know, and you cannot even comprehend now, what the mayhem mankind has got himself into it with this blue box. You walked in for a free energy, I gave you the freedom of your life. But now you have to manipulate it, how you want to use it. The way you want to use it, you want to use it as a heat, you want to use it as a food, you want to use it for whatever else you need. This is the power source. In fact, what this is, exactly, is what we showed up here. Is the sun, which radiates energy, but now you carry the sun. The energy resources of mankind is in his own hand, because in a space that's what you need. If you twist it, turn it, it does not make any difference. The reality is now the knowledge is free. It's you who got to manipulate it, it's you who got to share it correctly, and then we'll find a bunch of monkeys who run around, they're still playing monkey game. That's no problem for any of us, because the reality is, by the end of this year, millions of these, thank you very much, just one is enough. By the end of this year, millions of these are made, used, people see the benefits, and as I explained last night, the governments who understood, they wanted to test it to understand, they have released the technology to the nation. I thank the Nigerian government for this move, and we support them fully. The minute we complete our deliveries, the first units will be delivered to the embassy of the Nigeria, because they took the first step. We've shown our work. When the Italian government allowed us, and they attended the first ambassadorial meeting, or second ambassadorial meeting, broke rank with EU and NATO, we moved to Italy for their support, and they gave us the sanction and the support, and now you see what happened. Now we see the same thing will happen in Nigeria. We open Africa in no time, because there are no professors who have. I've never seen a professor giraffe or a professor lion. They're all in Africa, so they're all needed. They'll all be delivered in a very fast way. But now, please use it wisely and correctly. And I'll tell you something, the first 300,000 euro bill for the people who use our systems has been issued. We put it on the internet, and we send bailiffs for collection within 7 days. So, you have the first 300,000 income will come to the foundation from the misuse of a logo of people on us, using us as a charity organization for their promotion. We put the bill up on the internet, and 7 days from today, we send bailiffs to collect the money. And that 300,000 will become 300,000 units for Africa, Congo, as we promised. So we have structured and we act. On 7 days from today, bailiffs will knock on the door, are paid for it to collect. Nobody can say we haven't received it. It's your problem, we have a registered letter. You should have been home. So, Congo will receive a few thousand units once we freeze accounts and we cash and sell goods of the house to pay for it. We know there is some cash reserves or inheritance, we'll take it and we pay for Africa. Thank you very much for all your work. So, you have to understand a very simple process. At this moment, a lot of people have been waiting for free energy and free food. It's the responsibility of the Keshe Foundation supporters worldwide to distribute this technology as fast as possible, the easiest way as to do. You've never seen such an evolution. No one, the way Renan did yesterday, opens in the factory to show you even how he's making his materials. This is the openness we expect from all the followers of the Keshe Foundation. You use our technology to benefit, carry our ethos, work the way we do. I can go into a lot of nitty-gritties and how to make the caustic to make it very elaborate, but the reality doesn't change. We abused the copper the wrong way, it gave us vibration, electron. We use it the right way, it gives us the freedom for everything. So, we advise you, please, you've seen it, you've seen the first blueprint coming out from the Keshe Foundation Research and Development, and we will see the whole procedure. We tell you how to connect. When we release the blueprint on Monday, on Friday, we show, it's shown how to connect, the way to connect. Even one of our team, he's doing a lot of work in the background, I thank him for all his effort, has taken the pictures of even where to connect the car supply power unit to get the maximum efficiency. He's actually show you a demonstration where is the best point in your car to put the car unit to get the best work. We'll release those all on Friday. So, please finish your homework by tomorrow, have your plates ready. You don't need to have the fancy, trays like this. These are all 3D printers. All you need to do is get yourself a soup plate and put your system on the soup plate, a plastic one, and just make it two little holes to put the wires through it, connect it up and down. And if you have, if you are Italian, you are this time in advantage. Yes, he says. Do you know why? Here it's very difficult, you have to find how to separate the plates, because they have to be equal distance. In Italy, we have something called pizza stacker. You put your pizzas in it, don't you? So, pizza stackers become very handy now. The Italians have a step up this time. Now, we go to a little bit of understanding more in dimension. This is important. You've seen this. This is a rough sketch. Understand the principle behind it. the distance between this plate and this plate has to be precise. You cannot be out more than 2-3 millimeters for perfect work. The size of the gap here and here, I cannot redo, can I? I've got to find out a way that it can go backwards. Let's see if it does this. No, no, it doesn't do it. Go back. Can I get my thingy back? Okay, undo. Let's see, undo. Oh, once again, undo again. Oh. Yes, I did. It's back. Now we don't need to worry when we rub it up. So, there is my ring. It reflects back and it does that. The gap there has to be correct. The circumference, the diameter has to be correct. And you can not make a mistake. All these distances have to be measured. The measurement is like this. Maybe I can show it without going on to that. Let's go up here. I don't know. Yeah. This is your, if you remember, the smaller core in the center. Yeah? The diameter of this is like this. This is flat. Fabio! Sorry about that. This is the flat, when it's flat. Yeah? So, it has a diameter. If you turn it on its axis, should be the same diameter. So, when you come to this plate, when you have this here, when you turn it, the gap should be the same on both sides. So, if you look at it, this is important, otherwise you get deficiencies. It's no problem, undo. So, this diameter here has to be this diameter here. Sorry, this diameter here should be the diameter between top and bottom. We estimate this is about 5 centimeters or so. So, 2.5 to 3 centimeters should not be more than the gap between your plates. If you look, it's measured exactly, but you have 2.5 from the top, 2.5 from the bottom, so you get the distance. When you rotate the plasmas should not be as the three plasmas. Plasmas should be as one. Then, when you see, is in fact this behavior. If the separation is too much, you have a cluster of plasma here, a cluster of plasma here, then you have interference and interaction between plasmas. But if you make them all, it becomes a bigger plasma. So, this is important. As the dimension to remember why we choose the gaps and the distances, and that's what I explained to you. You measure your coil, your inner coil size is, when it's turned around, should be the gap or your distance. But don't forget, you have another inner coil which they sit inside each other, at about 2.5 centimeter for 60 counts is just about right, and you get a perfect homogeneous system. So the Italians are ahead this time. She's happy, she says, yes. Are there any questions? No questions? One question. Are we online or off the online?
No, I'm here.
You're there. Just wait, we don't have enough battery in this. Giovanni, it's died. It's red. I'll leave it with you. It's a red color. Is the battery dead?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, are there any questions so we can get the microphone working?
I have a question, Mr. Keshe.
Who's speaking?
My name is John. I'm the guy that plays your music.
From where?
From Chilliwack, BC.
I don't know where it is.
Just outside of Vancouver.
That's Canada.
Oh, British Columbia. Oh, Canadian.
Yes.
Okay.
My question is, it's actually two parts, but they're both related. One is the perfection of the circle, if it needs to be a very precise circle, and also the spacing between the ends of the coils that make that circle. Is there any?
Not really. No, we haven't seen. You can go to become perfectionist, but by the time I don't have the final plate here. The final plate is totally different than what you see. I have to... Can you open... Just one second, we try. Can you open the bottom of this? This has to come out. If you can open it, can you put it? It's... If you can take it out, can you take the trays out? I'll show you how it works in partially, because we made a number of prototypes, 3D prototypes, to get the optimum structure, and we have seen no difference in power. The only thing you got to be very careful, please make sure when you're twisting all these wires together, you don't cross each other. Come up with a neat system, plan it before you link them, and you will see it works very, very easily. You have a continuous homogeneous layer, and make sure, absolutely important to make sure, that at this point of where you connect the wire from the power supply to your stacker, you use the same or near enough. Yeah, okay, that's perfect. Thank you very much. Okay, this is the unit. I'm going to show it to you a different way. You make sure, yeah, you can leave the cover there, please. Leave it there. You got to make sure the wire you bring in, this wire, the thickness of the copper wires from this unit, these have been changed to 2.8 now. This is 1.75. We changed it the last minute yesterday, the day before, because we saw a improvement, so the factory immediately changed before the units go up. So the dimension of your wire coming in has to be as close as to this, that the power transmission is not the same. This is the only point which you fail. If your system fails and it doesn't work, only fails, and only fails at this point. The interaction between the matter of the copper wire which is coming, don't forget, you cannot put a screw or knot you have to do the same thing. You have to twist the wire from this onto the first step of your plate. You cannot use a screwdriver or get a nut and use a junction. The minute you put one of these old-fashioned things on it, called a screw, you damage the nanolayer, you are, as we say, bird for the cat. The beginning of the failure of the system. Never use anything, just twisting the field transfer. You have to move into the state of mind of you are not dealing with matter anymore, you're dealing with the transfer of magnetic gravitational field in a plasma state. So, if you see a big spark and the system doesn't work, it means you plugged it first the wrong way, and when you plug it the wrong way, this here has melted. So, in the factory, we twist it, we do it, we seal it with a special tape, that stays solid. But if you overload it, that point is the only point of failure. When you load it, when you put your load on, you never hardly will see any breakage here. Because the plasma transfer has no problem. At the interface of, as the interface of matter state is where the problem comes. Because very fast from here to here gets nano-coated. Within first few hours you put it in, so this up to here is a plasma state. The problem comes here. When you start this end, these are the things when you do it at home you have to watch. Try to pick a wire very near in diameter, that at least it can carry the power through. Especially if you are making the car units. Don't forget, for the car units you connect to battery of the car, you have a huge power transmission. And you have a condition. It takes time. You'll find out in a matter of few weeks, your battery in the car is totally nano-coated. It works as a plasma center. It doesn't work as a normal battery anymore. The transmission of the energy will go through the power and it becomes part of the evolution of the emotion or evolution of the system. That's why you save energy. Because now you have created where in the car you feed yourself back in. So it's irrelevant if you make a gap between the ends or not, if it's semi, what do you call it, full circle, or there is a little openness, no, there is no difference. Excuse me, I've got a very bad cold, I'll take some water. If I open these plates, this was the original design. This is the spacing. You see, the spacing is, from the beginning, has been considered to be they sit inside each other in a way that they accommodate the push and the pull of the system. They allow the wiring, the gaps, and these are the plates. You see, they were supposed to sit. This has been changed now totally. But if you look at it, it sits perfectly inside the gap. And the gap is about 1 centimeter in the center. And you still have the same hole in the middle for the GANS material to be in the center. And these spacing is very important, as I explained, and if you understood it, where they sit on a specific position here, and you have your gap. And then you have your next stacker, and then you have your gap. The here the grooves made where the wires go through, but it's been made much simpler now in the factory. And this is how it sits. We put a group protective on it, but more or less for mass production, something like this is used, where the wires come out and the assembly is done outside. And this assembly sits where here we have gaps for these assemblies, where the wires can go through. So, you've seen the beginning of evolution. I'm sure in the coming weeks, even we have started producing miniature systems. Very, very small systems. Systems more or less we can fit into the whole system will be smaller than this. We are now developing a system where you can use it as a plug-in. You take your system and you plug it anywhere. It has enough to do the transfer on the spot. You don't need to be in a power supply chain. So, in the next couple of weeks, we release new products, which is on the back of this. So, you can get a plug-in for water, you can get a plug-in for vitamins, or you can get a plug-in for different things for the plasma. The next stage is the biggest problem was to get the first units out. Now, the first units are more or less out of the factory. It's not in our hand anymore. So, we see, and as we said, if any government or any agency is like trying to find an excuse to block the delivery, nobody can stop you from delivering copper wires and some plastic plates. It'll cost double, but it means we can give less to the foundations around the world to support them. But we managed to get the technology across worldwide. Any other question?
There's no shortage of questions, actually. Let me see.
Are we still on number 45?
Well, we have... Today there's 46 open and 38 have been answered so far. But some of them aren't really technical questions or proper questions in a way. So, like someone is wondering if they could visit the center and maybe organize a visit and tours.
What, you think we are a zoo?
You might have to put bars on the doors, yeah.
First of all, factory would not be released. The place of the factory will be kept as it is. Only we could keep it that way for it to be safe for security reasons and the workers' security reasons. And secondly, the doors of the Keshe Foundation here at Research Center are open. But we have to know, because it's not a cattle market. And secondly, for our security reasons, we have to know who's here, why they're here. We stop anybody walking in who's just come to see. As I said, this is not a safari park and we're not the animals in it.
Okay, so someone should have some kind of proper business to be not just
yes,
touring.
If you want to come, we have to know, we have to, because we've seen this, it should stop. It's open door policy, but has to be some limitation to it, because not everybody can walk in or walk out. Because in the coming weeks, this become a research center, as is now, the other building has been acquired for this site. The fifth floor comes into operation. It's a continuous from now on. research and development and teaching and evolution of the technology to do commercialization. Part of the work staff of the Rome office of the Keshe Foundation Development Factory will move into this building. That we don't need to be continuously going to Rome and come back. So the minute something is developed in assessment, we'll go upstairs, prototyped within hours, within days, is produced in the factory. The whole structure has been set up, there is nothing to stop. It's just that finding the manpower to do it the way it is. The factory backend is totally secure. We already employ nearly about 100 people with all the team. As you see, I don't go anywhere, but everything is done, delivered, manufactured. We have brought in a very good team of partners to work with us. It's 100% trust in what we release to them and what they deliver. You will see the unit hopefully tomorrow morning, if we can get here. If the courier can get here, you will see the first three units which came off the production line. They're historically will be kept here, will not be released. And that's how you will see exactly the copy of what you will receive.
There's a question, Mr. Keshe. Do you have enough manpower to produce all these units? I know there's...
There are over 7 million unemployed in Italy. And you've seen it. To produce these things, you don't need to be genius monkey.
And there'll be another model coming from the Philippines to cover that area, I understand. Is that correct?
Yes, we are organizing now with Germany. Hopefully, Germany, within the next couple of weeks, will come into operation. We are working with America. Armin is on his way this weekend to US to start the production. I'm hoping that we set up the organization of production in Nigeria, now that we have opened up the right direction with the government there. We see what the biggest gap in the foundation at the moment is India. We have a huge problem in India. There are a large number of people who are around the foundation in India, and the company Keshe Foundation Manufacturing, as we speak, this week has been set up in Japan. So we're going to production in a very short time in Japan. I had a telephone call this morning that company structure has been set up. Keshe Foundation, or me personally, that my assets will go to the foundation after my death, is 51% owner in all the structures. That we do not get the assets to be sold off by anyone. Anybody can sell their own shares, but the structure stands for the nation. Keshe Foundation Italy.org has already been set up. We are here, and the production company is well established and working. You got to understand, even making these samples, taking a lot of time. This is not my man job. About 10-15 people worked nearly a week. I was there the last 2-3 days. And if you were in the presentation, the last minute, literally last half an hour, it came from the factory people. They delivered it by hand. We have a very good team. The good team structure is coming around the foundation because people think and work on the same ethos. The ones who come to rob, they rob themselves. We've seen it, it's happened, and it's happening more. And we've seen that even the people who try to cause problems for the foundation as money laundering, they've come into a very big, big, big mud. Because now it's perjury. Wasting police time by lying and deception, deliberate, putting it on the internet and getting other people to say Keshe Foundation laundering money is to get the banks and the police to move. Now they have all the emails. The arrest is coming up. I'm writing the last papers for the police. You got to understand, we work correct, we stay correct. It's your problem, you have a problem with yourself to sort out. As I said, 7 days from today, bailiffs will knock on the door for the first 300,000 euro for use of the Keshe Foundation spaces for advertising your place. And then we submit the 15 million euro to the court of Belgium for cashing in. Used for 7 years. Does not matter who says they haven't replied, it's been in public, it's been delivered. We are absolutely relentless in serving humanity, but the ones who cause the problem have to stand their own spaces. You've seen it, the people who went wrong with us, we didn't do anything. The Chinese government securities released their tapes, not us. Because we work very closely with the governments, we explain to them what we do, they provide us the protection. If you work with Keshe Foundation and something goes wrong, not done deliberately, we support you. We stand next to you to every point. But if it's done to damage us, you don't want to get on the wrong side of the law where you've done the wrong thing, not with us. So if you set up Keshe Foundations and something goes wrong, you set up Keshe Foundation manufacturing and something goes wrong out of your hand, we stand by you, we support you. Because no man intentionally goes to damage unless it's criminally minded. So when you set up the Keshe Foundations in Africa, in Asia, in Europe, we support you in every shape or form, financially, scientifically, research-wise, even manpower-wise. But you have to understand, you have to work with the ethos of the Keshe Foundation to share unconditionally. Do not go around trying to patent. Because it's very easy, the patent office doesn't know, we'll give it to you, but if you can send documents to patent that this material has been in the market for years, for months, the patent is revoked. It's that easy. You just pay money for nothing to the wall. Next question. Can I advise you, when you receive your units, maybe in next 2 or 3 days, please, before you use them, confirm to us that you received it, that we know the package has arrived. Secondly, when you open the package, read the paper on top. It says, do not overload over 2 kilowatts, it's the maximum. It gives you a link that you can go to that link before you do anything with your system. Takes you mainly to the blueprint, gets you to the connection section, how to connect your system, and tells you the things you have to do and you don't have to do. And then it tells you, make sure you understand the polarity of your power. Because this is a DC, polarity, positive, negative counts. It's very much like, if you want to understand it, it's like this. I can speak, if the battery in this system you understand? That's how simple it is. You have to place the live wire in the right phase to feed the gravitational central system. If you don't do it, you connect it, the system goes backwards. Instead of you feeding here, you're feeding there, and then you see the system. Your own system pauses and it creates a big bang.
Mr. Keshe, some people are a bit confused about the gravitational versus magnetical difference in the fields, I guess, compared to the winding, because they're saying the gravitational is clockwise and magnetical is anti-clockwise, and they're confusing that with the coil.
All your springs, all of them, in all the sets, has to be winded anti-clock. When you connect your system, the gravitational system's connection, you go anti-clock for gravity and clockwise for magnetical. So when you connect your gravitational, which is the center bar inside the gravitation, which has gone through the center bar, you go gravity to the gravity. And then you go clockwise outside, anti-clockwise, clockwise inside the bigger one, and then you go to the center anti-clock for magnetical. You gather all the gravities together, and then you push it out in the magnetical. Gravity goes clockwise, connection, and then when you connect to magnetical, you go anti-clockwise. The process is supportive on its own. There is a version which we might put into the market. We don't see any reason for it except one way in the future, where we will create a different combination. The different combination is for literally softer plasma, not such a heavy plasma. You need softer plasma if you are going for certain type of end products. When we release the blueprint on Monday and Friday, you will see it. Any other question?
You got. Here's a tough question.
Oh my God! You answered it. When is toughest for you?
Well, it's interesting. It's Delph says there's going to be chaos when we can build Magrav power. But what about the food and sustenance? Shouldn't we have been taught about these plug-ins for water and food ahead of time in preparation?
About 5 minutes ago, now he wants us something wrong.
We're doing it the wrong way. Preparation for the expected mayhem. Yes.
We can never keep this human race happy. There's always something wrong.
And then once they have food and water, they'll want TV games and et cetera.
Yeah, and then it comes, why don't we go to the moon? We already been to the moon, it's not good enough. Why don't you go to the Mars?
Yes. And it's only this solar system? How come we're not in Alpha Centauri by now?
Why can't we see the Martians?
And, well... That's what keeps us going.
Never, you can never, what do you call it, close the mouth of the matter. Because the brain is too small, it has to come something out of it.
But that's what keeps us going. We're always curious and grass is greener on the other side of the hill and all that sort of thing. Otherwise, if we knew the grass was brown on the other side of the hill, we wouldn't go anywhere.
You got to realize something. You hear this voice in the background? Rick?
Yeah, I didn't announce myself.
I can tell you 90% of what you've seen in Progress of Keshe Foundation is because of this voice. He decided, I'm going to do something. I'm going to put it out. And you've seen, it's built up. Thank you very much, Rick, for all the things you've done for the Foundation.
And that's true, Mr. Keshe. I did decide one day that it was needed to be done, and I said, if not me, who? And if not now, when? And that started a thing a few years ago, and it's developed to what it is now. Isn't that amazing? Thank you for so much of your efforts, Mr. Keshe. You're at it all the time. It's amazing.
Let's see where we go from now on. I tell you one thing. I read a report this morning, very small. Governments are talking what to do. I might have a surprise for you tomorrow if we can come to an agreement tonight. it'll be a very good news for the Keshe Foundation worldwide. And if we come to an agreement tonight with the people, we have achieved a major breakthrough in world peace. In a very small way, but a very effective way.
Isn't it already planned, Mr. Keshe? I've seen some pictures from Mike about the next Time magazine front Pardon? Cover.
What?
I said I've seen some pictures from Mike and Nashif about the next Time magazine cover. I'm not sure if it's true or not, but it lays the groundwork for different technology.
I don't know. I haven't seen it. You have to realize that for past 7 years, 8 years, the Iranian government did everything to protect it, that it does not go out of hand. And now we have released it. It's in the hand of the people, not what government to protect it. That's why if you were in Iran, you couldn't even find the Keshe Foundation website or anything about Keshe Foundation. Because they knew our lives was at risk if we would have shown a full support from Iran. And they protected us heavily. And I thank for the offices of all the presidents, and especially His Eminence Ayatollah Khamenei, to come up with such a wise plan. Till we don't go public, we stay and keep it very low, that we protect our scientists. As you know, one of the leading Iranian nuclear physicists was murdered, not past couple of weeks, in a different way, past 2 or 3 weeks, and they're still on the same path of killing scientists. It took a lot of bravery, a lot of work, to be able to bring this science and this technology out today. A number of Iranian nuclear physicists are missing at the moment, just through the same process. It's been a miracle that we managed to get this technology through and go public with it. We lost a number of good friends in the Iranian nuclear industry, and in the recent past days, we lost more. It's a shame to the governments who do it, but now the turning time has come. Any other question? Good question. The microphone.
It's on.
It's on. Yes, it's green. It's on.
Sorry, Mr. Keshe, I know you've already repeated this, but the actual wires that come out, there's a gravitational and a magnetic. And I don't understand when you connect. Do you connect it, the gravitational to the magnetic, or the, do you continue
no,
the line?
No, you have two sets. You have two sets.
Yeah.
Each set has its own gravitational and its own magnetical. You have a smaller set in the middle and a bigger set outside it. And the gravitational of the small one connects to the gravitational of the bigger one going clockwise. And then when you come out of the bigger one, you go back to the center into the magnetical anti-clockwise. And then when it comes out, you go to the bigger one anti-clockwise and you take your energy out. The, okay. The understanding is this. Understand why. Understanding is very simple. You have your magnetical field, that's what goes out. You have your gravitational field. You have the same, I try to do them here, my ring is the problem, I know that. this is, if I can do it this way, and then you have this. You connect the smaller one is gravitational to the gravitation, and then you connect. When you finish with it, in a way you connect this back to here. You connect inside, for example, to here. And then you connect this one to here. You connect the gravitational to gravitational, and then you take from magnetical, because you add the field forces together, and then you feed it out. And then it feeds itself. When two plasmas interact, they create loop of infinity.
Thank you.
If you look at the loop of infinity, it's very simple. Undo. From here to here is magnetical. From here to here is magnetical. From here to here is gravitational. Marco tried to explain this yesterday. Remember. So, what you have here in the background, this is a feedback. That you always keep everything inside the pack. What is gravitational? Becomes magnetical by going through, by going through. Any other question? What's the time, please? Pardon? 12:30. You paid for another 30 minutes of acting, and that's his finish, as they said, he's a very good actor. We played the act of the planet. Let's see how the show ends up. So, any other question? By the way, you Italians, sorry, you Canadians, congratulations, you got a new Prime Minister. It seems like.
Yes, that's right, and he...
You think the sanity will come back to the nation?
There's a good chance he has a heart.
Is it because of his name?
Partly. Well,
actually, he has vowed to release the strangle, in quotations, that was held on scientists. So, I think it might be a good thing.
Yes, and he's also, besides being actually interested in science and having a crew with him that are interested in that, they're also interested in the rights for the Aboriginals in Canada and all around the world, and also women's rights. So half of the new cabinet will be women, and there'll be a high number of Aboriginals as well involved in the new government. So we have a chance. It is like a breath of fresh air here, I find,
So do Iranian scientists exist now, or they don't exist anymore?
Well, this is what we'll find out, because I will push to have the government of Canada produce an apology to Mr. Keshe and try to... Well, they actually do have a program. They want to establish relationships with Iran, as well as Russia, China, and so on. And they have a good grasp of... a peaceful way to go into world politics. One of the first things they say is they're going to stop the bombing of using Canadian jets to bomb Syria, and they're agreed to stop the killing, is what they are saying, and will probably follow through on.
Anyway, hope so, you find a peaceful nation.
If we can get them to sign the peace, your peace agreement, then that would be excellent.
Any other question, or we call it a day and we go into the plasma for the blueprint?
Well, you certainly covered a lot today, Mr. Keshe. There's still probably some questions about the exact wiring connections, but you mentioned you're going to have that as part of what's released on Friday and
does
so on.
Does anybody in the background wants to show what they developed up to now?
That's a good question. We had, Vince, didn't we have a couple of people earlier that would like to do that?
I seen Mark there. He was sharing his screen. I'm not sure what he was sharing, but he wasn't able to talk, so...
Give him a voice and let's see what he can show us.
If he has a voice, yes. If he doesn't, then let's move on to anybody else that has anything to show. If you could just raise your hand if you're in the
viewer. Is Richard there? Or?
Oh, Richard is there. I'm not sure if he can talk. Richard, are you able to talk?
Have you got your tongue?
Yeah, my tongue. I'm sitting here. Make sure I'm looking after the kids today, so I have the afternoon to play around.
Pardon?
I have the afternoon to play around, not today, in the morning, so I'm just taking notes here. But you can see my latest pictures on Facebook. I just nanocoded the...
Do you live in a museum, or is just the picture behind you?
No, this is my my main cave.
What is a locomotive? How come from locomotive you joined the plasma world?
No, this is ancient stuff.
Why don't you show them using it? No other antique stuff.
That's his business, right? It's your business, part of what you do, Richard?
This is a real big hobby of mine. I just collect antiques and old stuff from, well, the turn of the century, 1850 till 1920s. I like the period because a lot of stuff happens in that period. So
it looks well nano coated from that time too.
Yeah, I love the copper and the brass in these materials, because it's really like a nicer look to things.
A very strange hobby for a policeman.
Yeah, well, I had to do something else.
You have any hats you collected?
No, I don't collect hats. No. I have all kinds of things. Okay. But that's not the business right now, right?
Yeah. What about your nanomaterial?
Do you want me to show some pictures? Do you want me to show some pictures of the... And the nanocoding process.
Yeah. Have you managed to put the GANs on it yet?
I'm drying the GANs now. So I was still flushing it because it had salt content still in it. So I had to put some demineralized water in it to get the salt content out. And now it's actually still settling down. And I'm going to probably heat it this afternoon to get the vapor out. Moisture.
Don't forget to add a couple of drops of your caustic into it.
Okay, I'll do that.
Okay, so you can't show us anything else?
Not live on camera. I can show you the pictures, but
do you think by tomorrow morning we can see your energy unit? You bought your plates?
I've got everything around, yeah.
You got everything around. Okay, no problem. We'll see you most probably tomorrow.
Yeah, or in the middle of the night.
Richard, did you want to share your pictures? That'd be great.
I'm just to check how I'll do that. I'll go there.
I wonder what your wife says when you say the energy at home is free now.
I was going to say some anti-glare glasses would be great too.
It's not there. I think he's disconnected.
I think he tried to share his picture and he got disconnected, yes.
Well, no problem. Is there anybody else we can share pictures with? I saw a big box on a couple of chairs this morning.
Yeah, that was Martin. Mark. That was Mark. We were just trying to get the voice working. I'm not sure if it's working yet. Mark, can you say something? Still no voice from Mark.
No voice. Anybody else?
I did promote two more people, Martin and Joe. Did you guys have anything to show?
If nobody can show any unit by Friday, how can we show the blueprint? There is no proof of it. So, we leave it till next year.
So, because I've heard that yesterday evening, I just rushed to a shop. I bought 100 meters of MCU 2.5 square millimeters cable in the morning. Since 5:30 till 9:30, I stripped it all. For stripping, I use the potato peeler. It's very easy to remove the insulation. And also, I've got such a power tool to easier make it with a 4 millimeter rod and a 10 millimeter rod. So now I have no desk to put a wrench there, not a wrench, how to say to this tool which you hold together. And so I have a small hobby table in which I have a front plate with a front board where I would drill a hole of 4 millimeter and the 10 millimeter hole for driving it as Richard has shown us, and also another two holes for the wires. So I hope.
Yeah, but how are you going to count the number of the turns?
I count it, of course. First, I will count here. I will measure the length and I put a mark with an alcohol filter pen to know from where to where I have to wind and where to stop the winding. So it's going on. If I will be lucky, maybe by tomorrow morning I'll have the coils and put them into a big box. I have a huge 4 liter box for nano coating. For making a faster nano coating, maybe it's not the most proper way, but I was inspired by Armen when once in a Wednesday morning of Europe time, Keshe Plasma Group meeting, he has shown a very nice black coating. Let me take it off from here. And I try to reproduce that method. How about its color? So this was a bare copper plate. I put it in the bottom of a plastic container.
Do you do all this sitting down?
Sorry?
I said, do you do all this but just by sitting there in that chair? I never see you anywhere else. You're always in that chair.
I can stand up, but you will not see my face in that case because my camera is fixed on the computer. Of course, I move somewhere. But when I
by Friday.
So I connected, I put in the plastic container at the bottom, I put, I had potassium hydroxide, I made a solution of about 20 grams to 1 liter of distilled water, and I found such a battery, it's a zinc battery, it's also good to recover some zinc if they get used. And I opened it to get a lower voltage, I put 3 volts only. To a pair of wires, I connected the negative, the minus pole, on the copper plate, and the positive I connected to graphite or carbon rod from the middle of a used battery, and I let it for about 1 hour until all the surface of the copper became of uniform color. So with this electric current, the top layers, top of the atoms get removed, and some will be nearby in a loose position. And I made a discovery because Armen told that he did that in not in caustic, but in salt solution, and later he used, after this electrochemical cleaning, he used the usual process with either vapor or immersion in caustic soda. I was a bit busy or lazy. So I put the plate in a wet condition in a box, and I left it there for a couple of days. I forgot about. When I went back, I came back to do the nano coating. I seen that already is black. The coating has been done with the leftover caustic, which was on the top of it. So I intend to use this method to make a faster nano coating. Otherwise, I should wait a couple of weeks to coat properly the coils. And in the meanwhile, this one I will set up with a zinc plate, and another piece I will set up with copper plates, and I will start producing more guns. The biggest trouble is to collect enough copper guns. It took me about 1 month to collect this little quantity with such a huge size plates, so it's not very fast process. For making other kind of guns, they produce a bit faster. Just I consume the guns of CO2 for flowers, so I have to make a new one. I don't know whether this one, which contained an iron electrode in it, is it usable, or better to avoid it due to possible influence with the hemoglobin.
There's a couple of questions about that, Mr. Keshe, whether to use that particular material in the GAN soup, let's say.
Try not to use hemoglobin. I'll explain to you the danger of it, and I'll explain to you the advantage of it. If you use...
How about the CH3?
Pardon?
How about the CH3 guns?
CH3 guns is no problem. There is a big difference between CH3 and red hemoglobin. We've seen it. You can produce liters of it. You can literally produce liters of it. If you add magnesium to it, you can produce everything you need. Oh, he's up. He woke up. It's Vince's little boy. He just woke up.
No, not mine.
Is it not yours? Oh, no, I didn't know.
6 o'clock in the morning. I hope not.
He's been hiding one sand, most probably. You can go into vegetation world. Teach you these things, how to do it, and how, then you set a standard for filtering. It's very easy, but it needs time for you to understand it. Then we send parameters for a new structure, where your filtering will be that whatever comes out of the filter, you don't see physically, but you feel, you taste if you want, and you receive the energy of the entity. Very simple, extremely simple. we will show you the present heating, even we do now, is not necessary. You want to feel warm in your skin, you don't want to feel warm there. You can create a condition that you feel warm, and you decide how much warm you want to be. In the next few weeks we show this very easily, that you don't need to create such a heating to heat the whole room. You want to be warm, the temperature you want, that's how you feel. Because that's what you receive from the system. Pardon?
Yeah, it looks here too.
Do you have something? Which paper did you lose? What I said is that we produce a system, we release a system soon, that you feel the temperature in your body, not in the environment. You...
Yeah, we just lost the... We lost the teacher camera computer, so...
I knew we were going a little too long there, and we should have wrapped things up.
Back in here, so just give me a moment here. Let me start the video again. Mr. Keshe, can you hear us now?
Okay, we just have a temporary glitch. I think we're coming back in here.
Yes.
There we go. Okay. We're back.
Here we go. We are here again?
Seem to be, yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes. What happened, what I was explaining is that in the coming time we'll show you technology where you feel through your emotion the temperature you want to feel. You don't need to heat up the environment. This is what happens in the space. So, in a space you don't keep a warm room all the time, wherever you are, with the temperature which you want. If you want a summertime, build with summertime. You want that temperature you're comfortable with, build with that temperature you're comfortable with. Your body does it with your blood, to keep it, in a way, in motion. Now, we teach the technology. How you create, you decide at what temperature the environment of the body or you are in will be. The pots and pans and the things will feel the temperature of the environment, but not your body. You don't feel, you don't need, nobody wear fur coats in the space, because we have no animals in the space. You control the temperature through your emotion. And you decide the boundary of the emotion in respect to the body of the man. So, what do you do if this is your... What I call, do you remember the movie called Simon Templar? He used to have a little hat there. Do you remember that? It shows your age, don't talk. So, in fact, if you look, if you can see this color, this is not a paint, this is a, what I call, like the aura of your body, you call it. You show you a system that controls the temperature adjacent to your body. So, you want to feel summertime in the middle of the winter, that's what will happen. That's what the aura does. The coldness or the heat of the environment is because this part keeps constant work. And then when the outside changes, you feel the difference. If you can adjust your emotion to the level that constantly stays the same as the environment, I have to undo, but it's undo. And undo. I lost my undo. Okay, undo. Edit. Undo. Okay, I got the lag back. So you decide through your emotion the temperature. If you don't understand it, I explain to you how it works. Women know this, and the body works through menopause. It starts sweating out of nowhere in the middle of the winter. You don't know that, you understand it 40 years time. That's what your body does. In the middle of the winter, you boil and then you freeze. Now I show you the technique, how you do it through the emotion and why body goes through what we call emotional sweat of the menopause. It's the fear of not being reproductive. So it's emotional based. And if you can use the same emotion, you can feel hot, cold, wherever you want, doesn't matter what temperature is. This is what you do in this space. That's what I said to you from the beginning. When you understand the work of the plasma, then you see how you can connect it to each other. You understood the work of the plasma in matter state, in the gas state, how emotion plasma is connected to the physicality, and then how you see the... If you know this, you know when you have a fear, you go hot, something, yeah? So, emotion controls the temperature of what you feel. So, you learn, and I teach you especially through this Magrav system, that you can be in the house, everybody else would like to be in a cold snow condition, you want to be warm, you do it, you'll be warm, they'll be cold. The rest are want to be hot and you want to be cold, you just do the same as you do. It's a very good idea, it bankrupts the air conditioning system world. So, we do it, we do it naturally. We do it, that's what we've done for millions of years. We just have temperature, the body temperature. And now, they understand the work of the plasma, we can show it how it's done. Because I don't need to show it to you, you already know it. You have built a system which is gravitational, magnetical, full covers the full spectrum of the energy. And if you understood that part, and you understood this part, you have everything. You decide where the temperature comes, the heat you want to be in. Fear or excitement gives you different behavior from your physicality, because your physical body is made of gas inside you. What as we explained before, is plasmas. So now through your emotion, you control the flow of plasma in the body. I want to be in the summer, 40 degrees in the middle of a snow, you stand, the snow's around you, you don't need anything. This is what you got to do in the space. You can't go and say, okay, I'm going to go and get my fur coat. You left 100,000 years ago, there are no fur coats in that space. There is no fur coats to get. Through your emotion, you change the Magrav state within the just the nano layer of your body, not beyond it. If I touch you, you're still cool. We have this problem in one of the tests at the moment, we're developing something. The man touches it, he knows his vibrating is in there, but I can't feel the temperature. So, now, this is the process you're going to learn. Control of emotion can lead to the temperature of the body of the man. And if you understand this, then you understand how you can control menopause, you can control fear and sweating and the rest of it. And it's very simple. It's already in the system. The system is gravitational magnetic field. You deal with the matter state here, but the emotion is at higher strength. So now you control if you want to be the environment 10 degrees or 20 degrees. It's happened to all of you, but now you understand the process. How many times said, I'm boiling inside and the people touch you, oh, you're so cold, why you think that way? But I feel hot inside, I'm burning. And then put yourself in a position, suddenly why? When it's not our way or physically, we can feel it, we measure, we go and buy a thermometer, it says we are 38 degrees or 40 degrees temperature. How come we can disguise it and sometimes we can show it? What is the difference? When it's in the matter state interaction of the plasma and the GANS, then the energy release manifests itself in the aura outside the boundary. When it's internally with the emotion and the physicality, you go inside. You sit down and you all eat curry and 3 out of 4, nothing happens. And the fourth one takes a shower. It's the same food. Have you been to one Indian restaurant? Seen how many people get to house? With me, it's a shower, I just collected. The other one's just, oh, there is no heat, there's nothing, it's normal. Because we changed the state of the emotion accepting temperature. And then you get an infection, you get the temperature and you can feel it, the others can feel it. Look, I'm sick, there is something wrong physically with me. But the blushing, the what I call menopause sweating is emotional. There is no feed temperature outside. Now you can learn to use the emotion, and as these systems are gravitational magnetic field of the higher strength, as you've seen it here, you control the emotion. In physicality, you can stand there, you can feel like being in the sun at 200 degrees. The same. No, because don't forget the heat is only a few centimeters, maybe half a kilometer from the surface of this planet. The rest is always cold. We have created a condition and we covered ourselves. But you can emotionally control, and within the systems, you learn very quickly how to do it. Heating will be a thing of the past. You can adjust, one of the things we'll show you, you can adjust the system that anything plastic in this room is 30 degrees, that when you touch it, it feels warm. The floor can be freezing. The technology opens up totally new doors, and people will start opening it. Each one of you will become specialized in one thing. Pardon? Warm water. Cold water, you want to feel it. Hot is hot. I'll show you how. You will see it. It's why some of us can drink hot water and the other ones can't tolerate ice water. Do you want me to invite him here? No, I haven't heard. Thing is, one of us are unique in our own way, but collectively now we can develop the technologies that it can affect all of us. Because now we can control both gravitational and magnetical and the full spectrum. If you control gravity in one end and magnetical in one end, or of a higher order, you will see. Because now it's you who decides. In a way, if you can, and it's very easy, we all do it, we decide we are so high, the lower is easier to chop up. You got to learn how, this is the way we're trying to teach you how to create plasma through your hand. How you change the emotion of a higher order in interaction with a lower order, and the interaction creates light and brings with itself dimension, new dimension in plasma. It's the same as always say, sun and earth. the interaction between gravitational magnetic field of the both, at some point here creates gravitational magnetic fields, which those who get in attracted to the gravity of the Earth, we see it as light. So now you decide where this point is going to be, and how light you want to receive. It's just a lot to come. You got 3 years here. By the time you go, you say, I didn't know it's that much there yet. I said, what's will be near 2 years? Would you like to have another 2 years? No, the wife will divorce you. Thank you very much for your time. We'll come after lunch. After lunch, we go back to the teaching of the plasma. As I said, this morning in the workshop, these systems was a way to teach the world the new life of energy, what we call the plasma. Thank you very much for all your time. See you in about an hour.
Okay, Mr. Keshe, thank you. I think there's maybe a couple.
That'll probably be about 2:30 your time then, in an hour.
Is it 1:30?
Almost. Quarter after or something.
It's 8 after I got.
Okay, we'll be here at 2 o'clock.
Okay, thank you.
You meant Italian time, I think, Vince.
Yeah, we'll see you at 2:30.
Okay, well, we'll try to be here at 2. Well, we will be at least, but whether they will, probably. Okay, so let's close the transmission for now. I'm going to close the live stream. Thank you everybody for attending. So Wednesday, October 28th, morning session for the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute, and it's the Blueprint Teaching Week. Thank you everybody for attending. Yes. Okay, I'll stop that.
By the way, is there some way to save these questions and answers?